Alright, so what is up guys? In today's video I'm going to be showing you guys how to etch into shoes. You can see I did this one. This was more my test shoe, but I will be doing it on the other side to show you guys how to do it properly. So what you're going to need for this is you're going to need acetone and cotton balls, and you're going to need a, a hot knife, or hot knife, yeah, I think it's what's called, hot blade. Yeah, but I got this from Harbor Freight for like $8. So yeah, if I can find a pair of Cyber Monday ones, I plan to do a fragment custom. So that is why I'm showing you this. I'll refer back to this video if I do that custom, if I can find a pair for the right price. So yeah, so first thing you want to do is you're going to want to plug in your hot knife, and you're going to want to let it heat up. So let's wait for that to heat up. So I'll get back to you guys after we do that. So next thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to let it dry, let it cool down, and once it cools down we're going to want to take a cotton ball with acetone on it. Let me focus this. There we go. Okay, so you're going to want to take a cotton ball and acetone to get rid of the shine along the edges, and more of the excess, like you can really see it up here, the excess, just to get rid of that and really smooth it out. So you can do this before you prep to paint a shoe, because I mean you're gonna still be prepping it anyway. So yeah, but if you don't plan on painting over it, you're gonna want to hit it up with a finisher afterwards, like Krylon matte finish. I think I have the clear gloss right here actually. Hold on, let me refocus. Oops. Yeah, I have the crystal clear gloss right here. My matte finish is right up there. So, yeah. So I'm gonna show you guys the cotton ball and acetone now. It's really nothing too crazy, so. so you can see how there's a bit of residue still on this part right here. It's like, it's like right there. A little bit of like it flow over, but I got these two. And you can see they're nice, clean, and neat. And they look like they were punched in rather than burnt in. So that's what you're gonna, what you'd have to do right after, to get rid of the residue. So, I mean, yeah, that's about it. So, thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to like, subscribe, leave some comments down below. Tell me what you guys think. I am trying to find donors right now for, my two cement threes, white cement threes that I have. So, yeah, I mean, I guess I'll get to that, in an upcoming video. It'll probably be a little while from now because I am starting school up here in a couple weeks. So, yeah, I am going to have to, I'm going to have to find some donors. So, thanks for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, and leave some, I just said that. So, all right, thanks for watching.